because the Jewish people could not. And hence they went to captivity several times. He then decided for his word to become man. Just like me, my word, if I have the capacity to make my word to become a human being, that being is me. Because my word is me.
So there's
no two God.
That's fine.
It is one God. Because you being a human being, you have the word, and you have a spirit, you have soul, and all these are one.
And it doesn't separate.
You don't have three men. Yes. I'm seeing one person.
My soul, my word is one.
It doesn't separate.
Yeah?
It does separate.
Okay, now.
Except if you separate.
Wait 1 second. You said that God was, that Jesus was given authority by the Father.
You come into that point, okay. Yeah?
Now, listen. You quoting the Bible doesn't mean anything to me. Because I don't
I don't believe.
Wait. I don't believe that your Bible is any proof for me. Or for anyone else, by the way. Do you agree?
If you say that, then you condemn your Quran.
No, wait.
You condemn your Quran straight away because your Quran made reference to the Bible. Quran, your Allah said, right? He gave his book. You know that?
No.
Relax. I want to clear something.
Relax. I have to finish my point.
No, we go step by step. But because it's recorded.
Don't let me speak.
I know the game.
I'm not playing a game.
You said something.
I'm going to interject
when you make it clear.
I'll be quiet.
I'm not playing right. Because the Quran, your Allah, even in his revelation to Muhammad, said Surah 5,
which is 44 to 48.
You see that I gave the Torah as a guide, right, to the Jewish people, and also gave the Injil, right, as a guide and as a light. When Allah, if you believe
Allah,
when Allah is God, and Allah says that what he gave is a guide, and as a light, then that is absolute.
Are you done?
Right? And then he said he gave the Torah. I will finish. And then he gave the Torah. So as far as I'm concerned, everything in the Bible and in the Quran that Allah said
education
is absolute and shahid.
Can I also know? First and foremost, we are not talking about what the Quran says about the Bible. We are talking about what you said when you quoted that passage in John, yeah? When you said that Jesus was given all authority by God. Yes?
Jesus said, I
have been given authority by the Father, yeah? Yeah. Now, my contention to you is this, is that we believe that God Almighty doesn't need any permission, any authority from no one. We believe God doesn't have any partners in his divinity.
That's true.
Now, how...
That's your belief.
Now,
don't you believe that?
No, but
does he not believe that?
No, he believes that, but then he says,
I don't believe,
but... Then he goes and says, but
Jesus
who was a fallible man...
So, I don't agree with that. You believe what you believe, let me believe what I believe.
That's not nice.
No, you are recording it. I won't allow you.
That's not nice.
No.
That's not nice.
I
let you speak.
No, he's recording it. Then I won't. Can you just say, I believe? I said, I don't believe.
You don't let me finish.
No.
You don't let me finish.
I would have forgotten.
Let me finish.
No, I go into that. When you make a comment that you said, I said. If I didn't say, I was
passing
through.
Excuse me.
Okay? No, if I finish, I will not be able to come back. I've been here for years. I know the game you play here. Go and watch YouTube and see the recording. YouTube. Go away.
I'm trying to have a discussion with you.
Yeah, but you know.
No, I'm trying to have a rational discussion.
I'm saying to you that we believe that God doesn't shape
banana people.
He has no partners. He doesn't need anyone to come and tell him, give him authority for anything. Now, if you say that Jesus was given authority by God, then you claim at the same time he shares the authority by God. I'm saying there's a contradiction here. Because it doesn't rationally make sense that if Jesus is God, he is to be given authority by someone else. Because then you have a problem here. You have a contradiction in your books. You can't say that Jesus, he was a fallible man, he walked the earth, you ate food, you went to the toilet, then the people pooped. I'm sorry for saying these things, by the way, but I have to say it because I'm not disrespecting Jesus, by the way. I love him, okay? But I'm trying to make you understand. I'm sorry for disrespecting you, okay?
No, not me. Okay. You're disrespecting Jesus. No, not me. Anyway. Because he can defend himself.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, you disrespect
on the day of judgment,
you will have to exactly.
Now, do you agree with me that it doesn't make rational sense for someone who's God to be someone to tell him that he needs
basically,
human authority?
Saying that
do you agree with me? Now, what is the difference? Now, second question is this. What is the difference between you and the polytheists who say, for example, the Hindus, they believe in 330 million gods. But at the same time, all these 330 million gods are one god. Yeah? This is my point. Now, you believe three beings in one being. My question is, what's the difference between you and the Hindus?
Right. I'm going to start by saying to you, the origin of Islam.
I asked you a question.
Islam started with 360 healers around the Kaaba.
Yes.
Right? And Muhammad made them one. So these are if gods that Muhammad made into one God.
No.
So you are just like the Muslims, you are just like the Indians that have so many gods.
Why are you so disrespectful to bring us down to your level?
The black stone, and the black stone is what now is your God, which you worship.
How can I
you kiss him?
Proper ignorance.
Well, you finish. No,
you believe in a God, but your slave masters put in your.
Are you listening?
You just finished.
You don't listen to me.
You just have to watch it.
To have a rational discussion with
you. You have to watch it. The difference. And yes. I'm saying to you, there is no difference between Islam and the Islam.
No, there is. Because right. We don't believe in that. We don't believe in
360
ilahs. We believe in one ilah. One ilah.
So you made all the ilahs into one. And because we ilah.
Listen, we don't believe in more than one ilah. You believe in three ilahs.
No,
don't say to me back in those days, because the thing got corrupted.
Let me come for you.
You're making things up. Do you believe in three ilahs, yes or no?
No, let me come.
Do you believe in three ilahs, yes or no?
No, I don't.
I don't
because here Jesus said, let me see what Jesus said. Let me see what
you don't believe in.
It's teaching the Bible. Is the word teaching about? Thank you very much. Now, you must admit that you've been lying. Now, let's listen to what Jesus says here. When we start a conversation, he said, for the Father loves his Son and showed him all things that himself does, and he will show him greater works than this, that you may marvel.
Yeah.
For as the Father raises the dead and gives life to them, even so the Son gives life to those to whom he will. For the Father judges no one, but has committed all judgment to the Son, that all should honor the Son, just as they honor the Father. He who does not honor the Son does not honor the Father who sent him.
Okay, now explain this. Because now you have a bigger problem. You know what it is? You have now two beings, equal power, which is even worse. You're in a bigger trouble now. Now you have two gods on the same level. Before you had the big god and the small god.
Have I not spoken about the word of God? Is Jesus the word of God?
Huh?
Is Jesus the word of God?
The word of God?
Yeah.
According to him.
According to your God Almighty.
Jesus
is the word of God.
Is the message
and
of God.
According to the Quran, is Isa the word of Allah?
He's a word from him, yes.
Is Isa the spirit of Allah?
Spirit. No.
Right? Have you got your Quran? Surah 4, verse 7.
In English wording.
Well,
in the comments.
Get your Quran, sir. I want your Quran.
I don't have a finger.
No, okay, I've got the Baraka.
You do the Quran, yeah? Okay, are we talking about the Bible?
No, I'm trying to prove to you.
Are we talking about the Bible?
You're just challenging me about Jesus being God.
All I'm saying,
I'm just telling you that the Word of God, no, the Word of God is God. Is the Word of God not God?
I'm talking too nice.
Is the Word of God not God?
Double camera. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, first, are we discussing the Quran or the Bible?
We are discussing Jesus, the Bible.
Okay,
but Jesus is the Word.
Jesus is the Word. We are discussing.
No, you can't listen to me. Why can't you listen when I'm speaking about the gospel?
I'm trying to listen to you.
No, listen.
You're not giving me trust.
Jesus said, I am.
Yeah.
The way. Jesus is the Word of God.
Okay.
The book of John said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Word became man.
I try not to be much.
We are trying to prove to you the divinity of Jesus, so that we can go through this. So that we can go to why Jesus is God. Because he
claims. Let me know when you finish.
Yes. So, I'm going to write that. Here Jesus is saying that the Father has committed all judgment. In other words, in the day of judgment, Jesus is going to judge mankind.
Yeah, that's all about
Jesus is going to judge you, me, and everyone of us.
I'm saying to you,
hey,
every time
they put him,
you're
going to
come out. But there's one video he said.
You know what it is?
This is
the way they're
right.
You allowed me. You kept me quiet. You made your record.
Let us go use the word. You're not sincere.
I can only use the word to deal with you. You see, you don't want to deal with me. Look, I'm using the Bible. I can't use
I don't believe in your Bible.
Well, if you don't believe in the Bible, then why are you writing?
It's not the word of God.
It's not the word of God. Is the Quran the word of Allah?
Your Bible has been
destroyed.
That's not the word of Allah. That's not the word of Allah. That's English translation from King James.
Is corrupt.
That's a King James.
You corrupt.
Do you have the original? Do you have the original? Do you have the original manuscript?
Allah said he gave the
Do you have the original manuscript?
Allah said
Do you have the original manuscript? Where is it?
Go and check it.
Where?
Go and check it.
Where? Which one?
Library.
Let me check it out.
Any library?
No, he's not going to claim.
Go and check. Your Quran,
let's auction
Allah said in the Quran that he gave the Torah, right?
What's the name of the manuscript? What's the name of the manuscript?
Sinaiticus.
What?
Codex Sinaiticus and Codex Vaticanus.
Codex
Sinaiticus and Codex Vaticanus.
And this is the original Bible.
Don't read it at your own time. Don't check. So, your Quran, your Allah, if Allah
reads it, so man claims he has the original Bible.
It's a revelation and not just a man-made thing. And Allah said that he gave the Torah.
Now,
as no.
Look, Allah said this he gave the Torah.
Wait. No, Allah said he's going to give the Torah.
Let's come to what's speak.
Wait.
You don't want me to continue.
Calm down.
Let me finish.
It's his turn.
I am
talk to the camera.
He said, they have a Bible. They have a Bible, which is the original Bible, meaning from the first century of Jesus time,
Okay, that's an
now, Codex Sinaiticus is dated 300 through 325. That's 300 years of Jesus' death.
That is dated.
I mean, do you know when Jesus lived?
When?
Do you know when he lived?
When? Well, that is dated 2,000 years ago.
That is what?
2,000 years ago.
2,000 years ago.
Yeah, Jesus lived.
Okay, the first century, yeah?
Yeah.
Now, the Codex Vaticanus, is dated 300 to 325.
Codex Vaticanus.
Well, the satanic is the same. Let's go there. Okay. Let's go there. That's fine. But do you accept me wrong about this?
I was not wrong. No. That is dating. Dating. Dating is different from what is written. Dating is the dating, not the day is written. 13. It is a supposition of when it was written.
How can it be the original word of Jesus when it's 300 years after Jesus' death?
Okay, let me answer your question.
No.
Yeah, it is question.
It is. It is because it is admittedly that the Quran, the Bible was not written while Jesus was alive. It was written between 15 and 25 years after Jesus' death.
He didn't die.
Right? Where you see that the stupidity of Quran, that he said Jesus did not die. While in the Quran, Jesus died.
Just talk.
Okay.
So Jesus died in the Quran.
So you don't have the four. You don't have the original.
Surah 4.
You don't have the original.
Surah 4, 1:5.
You don't have the original.
Said that Jesus died.
You know we have.
Prove it?
You know.
So that means he's not eternal.
You know our Quran.
Show me. Go to
has been preserved. Do you know that?
No.
Yes.
The Quran you're using today.
Did you know that?
Answer me. Is it Abu Bakr Quran or Uthman Quran?
Did you know that you have 4,000
the Quran you're using today?
Is Jesus eternal?
Answer me. The Quran you're using today, is it Abu Bakr Quran, Muhammad Quran, or Uthman Quran?
Abu Bakr Quran.
The Quran is Uthman Quran. The sanitized Quran.
What is Uthman
with
Quran?
All the errors.
Where is it?
And obligation.
Okay, where is it?
No, Abu Bakr Quran is wrong. All the manuscripts of this radio. One has to be realistic.
Do that picture. His own mission is to come here and give us a headache.
No,
and give us a headache.
It's the truth.
Drive us insane. The truth make us laugh. And then I say, he's on his
own. No,
yeah, yeah, yeah. You know, bugger. Nice old bugger. You know what he's trying to do.
Watch him.
I've got a headache already.
Shalom, brother. Shalom.
Shalom.